Have you ever wondered how much horsepower it takes to lift a massive 50,000 pounds load with a hydraulic cylinder? In this video, we'll break it all down step by step. From choosing the right cylinder and pump size to calculating the power and electrical requirements, you'll learn exactly what it takes to make a hydraulic system handle such an incredible load. Let's dive into it. All right, let's start with the basics, the hydraulic cylinder. We've got a 50,000 pound load, and we're working with a 6-inch bore cylinder. But how do we know if this is enough to handle the weight? Here's the formula. Force is equal to pressure multiplied by area. Given that the force is 50,000 pounds, we can calculate the required pressure by first finding the piston area. To determine the area, we'll start with the bore radius, which is half the bore diameter. In this case, 6 inches divided by 2. Since the area is equal to pi r squared, it calculates out to be 28.27 square inches. Now, to lift 50,000 pounds, the pressure required is 50,000 pounds divided by 28.27 square inches. So, we'll need about 1,769 psi to lift that 50,000 pound load with a 6-inch bore cylinder. That's a lot of pressure, but hydraulics can handle it. Now, let's talk about speed. How fast do we want to lift this load? Let's say the cylinder has a stroke of 36 inches, and we want the full stroke to complete in 30 seconds. We need to figure out the GPM, or gallons per minute, required to make that happen. First, we will calculate the volume of fluid the cylinder needs. Volume is equal to area multiplied by the stroke. With a stroke of 36 inches, it calculates to be 1,018 cubic inches. Now, we need to convert this to gallons. So the total volume is 4.4 gallons. To lift the load in 30 seconds, we need to double this for the GPM. We will need 8.8 gallons per minute to lift this load in 30 seconds. So the pump must deliver a minimum of 8.8 gallons per minute at 1,769 psi. Next up, powering the system. To figure out how much electrical power is needed, we need to calculate the motor horsepower required to run the pump. We'll assume the pump has an efficiency of about 85%. Here's the formula. To calculate horsepower, we take the pressure in psi, multiply it by the flow rate in GPM, then divide by 1714 multiplied by the efficiency factor. Now, using the values we calculated earlier, that gives us about 10.6 horsepower. A 10.6 horsepower motor isn't available as a standard size, so our best option is a 15 horsepower motor. We'll go with a 15 horsepower, 3-phase, 460 volt AC motor and calculate its current draw. Now, there are two ways to get this information. You can either look it up in Ugly's electrical references for a quick answer or calculate it manually. Using Ugly's reference, we find the full load current is 21 amps. Now let's calculate the breaker requirement. Typically, breaker size is set at 125% of the load. So, 125% of 21 amps gives us 26.25 amps, meaning we'll need a 30-amp breaker. But that's not all. We also need to ensure the breaker can handle the motor's initial inrush current, which can be up to 10 times the full load amps. So there you have it. We'll need a pump that can handle 8.8 gallons per minute at 1,769 psi, paired with a 15 horsepower motor and a 30-amp circuit breaker to keep it all running smoothly. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments what you think about these tutorials and what other types of videos you'd like to see on the channel. Your feedback helps shape future content.